Hello Python programmers, this is AK. In this video, we are going to learn about how to scrap the Amazon product prices using Python. Actually, this is one of the important mini project in scrapping. Here we use two Python modules to scrap the data from the Amazon website. So the modules that I used here are request and a beautiful soup. When you are planning to scrap any website using Python, then these libraries play a major role to extract the data from the sites. Most of the developers are using these libraries to collect the data from the websites. Mainly, scrapping the e-commerce sites provides more efficient and useful data. This data is stored and it is useful for many companies to track their own performances. So this is the applications of web scrapping. Okay. And this project is very useful for beginners and intermediate programmers in Python. So let's start the code. First, you need to import the request module. The request module is used to get the HTTP request from the website. And next, you need to import the beautiful soup. This is used to scrap the data from the websites. So these are the duties of these two modules. And then you need to write the headers. You need to set your headers for scrapping the data. Inside the headers, you need to write your user agent. The user agent means the browser that you use to scrap the data. So you simply understand this statement. We don't go further. Okay. And create a variable called. So first you need to create a variable called as response. Inside this variable, you need to mention your product link. So write request.get. This is an object. Inside this object, you need to paste your product link from the Amazon site. Here I pasted my dream laptop that I want to buy. It is an Apple MacBook 16-inch. Okay. So we are going to track this product price using Python. Next, we are going to start our scrapping process. First, you need to declare the variable soup. And inside this variable, you need to write the beautiful soup object and open the brackets. Inside these brackets, you need to write response.content and put the comma and call HTML parser. So I will explain this step more clearly. So using this step, we are going to get the HTML format of data from the Amazon product site. But it is the HTML format data only. We need to scrap the HTML contents to get the data from the website. Okay. And the next step is very, very important. You need to declare one function. I named this function as checkPrice. Inside the function, you need to create one variable that is title. First, we are going to scrap the title of our product and you need to write soup.find. This is an object. Inside the object, you need to pass the ID. ID is nothing but when you see the HTML format of data, you will notice the ID of our product. Okay, so this is our target. We need to scrap this ID, so call this ID. In the ID variable, you need to write the product title. Product title is a tag. Okay. If you want to scrap the product name, then you need to call this tag in your ID. Okay. So we are going to scrap the product name. So I called the product title tag first. Next, we are going to scrap the prices. For scrapping the prices, you need to declare the variable called as prices. Inside this variable, you need to write soup.find, same as the previous step, and in the variable you need to pass the ID. In the ID, you need to mention the tag that is called as price block out price. This will get the price data from the website. Okay. And the get text is used to get the data as a text format, so we can easily read the format without the interaction of the HTML data. Finally, you need to print the scrapped data. So print the two data. The first one is the product name and the second one is the product cost. And finally, you need to call your function. So this is the script, and then you need to click the run button to see the output. Look at the output. Our program works perfectly and it gets the correct results from the Amazon site. So viewers, say congrats to yourselves because you learned one of the important projects in Python, web scrapping. So that's all about this video. If you like this video, give a like and comment down your suggestions about this video. If you want more Python videos like this, then hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching and thank you.